everybody, and welcome to day 7 of our 12 days of Vlogmas. Today we're going to be making coquito, or a Puerto Rican eggnog. Well, it is Puerto Rican eggnog. If you didn't know, this strapping young fellow here, he is half African American, half Puerto Rican, and we got this recipe from his mother, so it is authentic.
As close to authentic as you can get, I guess.
Right. I trust her. She grew up in Puerto Rico. I trust her judgment. So we got our ingredients here. We got some spices, some extracts, an egg substitute. It's supposed to be made with real eggs. I'm a little funny about killing off the germs, so you can use an egg substitute. It does not change the flavor of the drink. So then we have evaporated milk. Can't make coquito without Puerto Rican rum. You can use other rums, but Bacardi is the way to go. We're not sponsored by them. If they want to cut a check, that's fine.
This is gluten-free.
So we also got some sweetened condensed milk over here, some prima coconut over here, and coconut milk. They're sitting in some warm water so they can separate because, congeal back together. That's what I meant to say. They separated because of the temperature from wherever they were. So let's get started. The first thing we're going to want to do, she want to add 4 egg yolks, or the equivalent of 4 egg yolks, which is going to be a cup of your egg beaters. This is a cup of the egg substitute, or the equivalent of 4 egg yolks. Yeah.
You do shake well, but I just shook it.
And then the best way to do it is incorporate your spices with the egg yolks and your extract before you mix everything else. And in here, I've already mixed a teaspoon of cinnamon, an 1/8 teaspoon of cloves, 1/8 teaspoon of, nutmeg? No, this is allspice, and an 1/8 teaspoon of nutmeg. And you're just gonna put these into your egg.
I've never heard of allspice.
I've heard of it when I've made like pies, like different type of pies called for allspice. And then of your extracts, you want to use 1 teaspoon of both, vanilla and coconut. Oh, I'm sorry. Here you go. 1 teaspoon of pure vanilla extract and 1 teaspoon of coconut extract.
Look how it goes up to the line, but doesn't spill over.
It is. And then we're gonna pop our top on and blend these.
No! Put the wrong top on it. Our vanilla extract's gonna have coconut in it. I have to make flan too.
Today?
No. Oh. It's for work.
And then we're just gonna blend that all up. That smells good.
Alright, what's next? I feel like we should put cinnamon in it.
Cinnamon is in it. Okay, so you wanna get your cream of coconut. It's a, 15 ounce can. I'm just gonna pour this whole can into there.
We don't waste product.
Oh my gosh. Then you're gonna add in a 14 ounce can of sweetened condensed milk. There's many brands, but we went with La Lachera. I just trust that it's, the best product to use today.
It's not, but I'll allow it.
Damn. Hey. What's the best?
I can't think. It starts with a C. It's like Carnation.
Carnation? They didn't have any. Like, literally.
And I wonder why.
Shut up. I went to go get some, and literally the whole section for Carnation was empty. They had this Eagle branding and the Great Value version.
I would have took Eagle brand.
I had it. I put it back for that. Okay, then next, we're going to add in our can of coconut milk.
The whole one?
Yeah, the whole can. Damn.
I didn't know.
Are you dripping on the table?
Dripping.
And last but certainly not least, we're going to add in 2 cups of this Bacardi. And I forgot about that. What is that? Evaporated milk. Sorry. We added in a whole can of evaporated milk. So now we're gonna add in the most important ingredient. You can use as little or as much rum as you would like. You can also use dark rum or spiced rum. And we're gonna add in 2 cups. And we're gonna blend this up. Thank you. Let me funnel.
All right, let's put this in the bottle.
You can use empty liquor bottles, or you can go to your nearest arts and crafts store. They sell these empty bottles. Get the 750.
Oh, we could have saved money. That's your mom.
Okay. Now we're going to bottle these up. You can use empty liquor bottles. You can go to your nearest arts and crafts store. They sell these in many different sizes. I just got the 750 milliliter kind. So we're just gonna pour this in and funnel this bad boy and get it into the refrigerator so we can have some time to get cold before our lit up like a Christmas tree party tonight.
I am to be trusted. Oh, I am to be trusted.
Oh, that looks so good.
You know this is gonna be gone.
Move to the next bottle.
I am to be trusted.
I'm gonna get us some cups so we can try it. So we're gonna cork these, get them into the refrigerator so they can have time to marinate and cool down. We went and got us some ice, so we're going to try our concoction of Coquito. Say it, babe.
Coquito.
You ready? Mm-hmm. Oh my God.
Gosh.
Oh my.
Ah. We're gonna have to make more.
Definitely. Just right?
Just right. It's like eggnog, but better. Ice is keeping it's holding it down.
P.O.P.
P.O.P. Clearly it's delicious.
Very.
I made a mess.
Tell me something I don't know.
It's also true.
That is how you make
Coquito.
There you go. I'm gonna leave the instructions and ingredients down below in the description box. Let us know if you make it. Let us know how it turned out for you. If you made some adjustments, let us know that too, because maybe your way may kick it up a notch. And we will see y'all in day 8, which is going to be our little like Christmas tree party, which is taking place in like 2 hours. Yeah, 2 hours at this point. We'll see y'all later.
Later. Call your mom now.
I am.